Hello, thank you so much for watching this talk. I'm Elizabeth Murnane, and this is work that's been the result of a big collaboration, as you can see, with a team of amazing people and advised by James Landay. Today, I'll be sharing our research to explore the design of ambient smartphone interfaces that use stories, narrative-based feedback, to reflect and motivate behavior. Specifically, we're looking at exercise behavior and promoting physical activity, given it's not only crucial to well-being, but a lack of activity is one of the biggest global health challenges we face today. Now, personal technology has the potential to help address this challenge, and in particular, broadly adopted sensor-laden smartphones and increasingly wearables provide substantial data about physical activity and enable interaction with users to try to motivate healthy behaviors in a way that's inexpensive, continuous, personalized, and at scale. The trouble is that while there are a ton of apps and devices out there to try to encourage people to move more, most aren't delivering on this potential. And a big part of the problem is the style of feedback these apps provide. Conventional formats that involve charts, graphs, statistical reports, a heavily quantitative approach. But research shows that people find this sort of health feedback hard to interpret and overwhelming. It can actually fuel negative mindsets, make physical activity seem distressing, and in the long run actually reduce motivation to exercise. In our research, we wanted to explore a more qualitative form of feedback that helps people engage with their data in more rich, intuitive ways. Given the relatable and persuasive power of stories, we specifically pursued the design of data-driven narratives. That is, we visualize a user's activity data and progress towards fitness goals through comic-like stories that comprise a multi-chapter quest that we deliver through ambient, glanceable smartphone wallpapers. So the basic idea is that our protagonist, Zuki, is this little space alien who ventures to Earth on a mission to save his planet and find his lost brother, encountering diverse scenes, characters, and conflicts along the way. And as a user logs activities and meets goals, the plot progresses, and Zuki similarly conquers his own challenges and reaches achievements. So let me first share a bit about our app and its main features. For tracking activities, we support both automated and manual logging to reduce tracking barriers and maximize capture of progress, while also enabling individuals to maintain control over their data. Specifically, we use the activity inference supplied by Google Fit to automatically detect walking, running, and biking. And by launching the app, users can review, edit, and delete recorded activities or add other activities, as well as set and review weekly exercise goals. We then visualize all these activities and achievements as components of a multi-chapter narrative that resides on a phone's lock screen and home screen, which provides at-a-glance feedback that further reduces barriers to information, especially considering statistics that people check their phones 80 to 200 times a day. And you'll notice the interface contains several types of real-time positive feedback. First, logged activities are stylized as small icons thematically related to the storyline of the current chapter. So in this space chapter, it's the stars in the sky. Each time a user logs a physical activity, a new icon is populated at the top of the screen. We encode activity type using different colors, blue for biking, red for running, yellow for walking, purple for other manually logged types of activities. And duration is encoded with icon size. Activities lasting less than 30 minutes are smaller, 30 to 60 minutes are medium size, and activities lasting more than 60 minutes get a bigger icon. Second, achievement towards goals is reflected by a progress indicator in the bottom right corner of the screen, together with the story unfolding. Specifically, each successive piece of the chapter gets visually and textually narrated as the user reaches 20%, 40%, 60, 80, 100% of her goals that week. So here, Zuki's getting progressively closer and closer to his own goal of reaching Earth in chapter one. Then once that 100% mark is reached, the next chapter is unlocked. And we designed 13 chapters that I'll scroll through now to provide at least a three-month-long experience to exceed the point by which research finds most existing apps are abandoned and the average sticking point for habit formation. And these chapters are all tied together by Zuki's backstory, an overarching plot that follows an episodic structure from exposition to rising action and climax to falling action and conclusion. We also employ narrative principles like characterization with our sympathetic protagonist and antagonist and dramatic challenges that the user has to help overcome throughout. And the narrative was really the key part. So we've worked closely with narratology professors from the English department in refining the story, as well as with users, doing multiple rounds of user studies to enhance the narrative's comprehensibility and allure. And just to be clear, there's a large body of knowledge around why narratives are compelling, which helps suggest levers we can pull as designers to create a story likely to be successful at motivating behavior. So I really encourage you to check out the paper to learn more about those theories and techniques. This iterative user-centered design process helped us not only to craft the storyline, but also hone the interface's look and feel and functionality, moving through early stage steps like storyboarding concepts, prototyping and testing, including with paper, like you can see here, to developing progressively more high-fidelity interfaces that we'd continue to vet and refine through large-scale online surveys, as well as smaller-scale in-lab interviews and user testing sessions. Fuller details are in the paper, and supplemental materials are available online, where you can poke deeper into all the narrative content, the app screens, and various design artifacts. For today, I want to focus more on insights we derive through this process, grouped around three main themes, related to the importance of designing to support intuitive visual communication, emotional richness, and thematic coherence. First, we found that visual components of the narrative mattered the most to people. They expressed a preference for the visual of the story to be comprehensible on its own, so we worked to improve standalone legibility of the visuals, short and lengthy accompanying text. Storylines that depended on too much text for context also hindered the glanceability of the display. So did things like where Android places notifications on the lock screen. So we put progress indicators at the top and bottom to avoid competing with other visual elements as much as possible. People also really liked having obvious visual markers of progress, including to celebrate achievement of goals. So we retooled where on the screen the feedback appeared and what direction it grew. We added this fun celebratory overlay once 100% progress was reached. And next, we saw that having an emotional attachment to the story was really central to maintaining engagement with the app, as well as engagement with one's fitness goals. For instance, originally the sole framing of the narrative was Zuki coming to Earth to save his home planet, but after user studies and given the motivational value of familism in narrative, we shifted the backstory to also include that the journey was driven by Zuki's mission to search and rescue his brother. He was here in a red hat. We had several variants to distinguish Zuki's brother. Turns out a mustache and beret simply do not convey vulnerable little brother, as well as a sideways baseball cap. We also identified a need for the story to be more emotionally arousing. There were several original chapters that people felt were predictable, which helped us rework content to invite more anticipation, cliffhangers, more suspenseful transitions, which we found kept people curious and engaged. And additional characters like an antagonist FBI agent simultaneously trying to hunt Zuki down or sidekicks that would help out along the way. These characters help raise and resolve conflict to maintain excitement and additional emotional richness for people. And finally, a big takeaway we saw was the need for the narrative experience to be coherent. For example, people really needed a logical relationship between completing fitness goals and the plot line. We'd had one chapter where Zuki rode a camel across a desert in an apparently leisurely way, and people really felt a disconnect with that. So we tweaked so the camel drops off Zuki after a point, who then needs to fend for himself a bit. Instead, people preferred chapters where Zuki's own challenge required climbing, jumping, swimming, physically exerting actions that connected better with their fitness mission and fostered that camaraderie with Zuki. So that's a kind of external coherence, a resonance between the user's actions and progress in real life and Zuki's actions and progress in the narrative. We also saw a need for internal coherence, with the interface containing consistent themes and aesthetics throughout. For example, early designs for some of our chapters used pretty generic progress indicators or activity icons, and participants noted those elements fell flat. So as a result, we revamped icons and imagery in several chapters to be more thematically cohesive, like a carabiner progress meter for a mountain climbing chapter, prickly pear activity icons for a desert chapter, and ensuring we didn't simply reuse the same activity icons across multiple chapters. And while seemingly small design choices, we were surprised by how much they mattered to participants and genuinely impacted their experience of the narrative. So we saw the little details really mattered. Now, after having iterated through phases of design and testing to identify insights like these and refine the system accordingly, the next essential step was to deploy Zuki to explore people's experience engaging with narrative-based feedback in everyday life. Given the exploratory descriptive nature of this pilot deployment, we focused on a small-scale sample, 16 participants. It was a three-week field trial involving in-person interviews, periodic surveys to gauge psychological attitudes and subjective experiences, and logs of physical activity and app use. We randomly assigned participants into one of four between subjects groups, which varied chapter length and whether or not notifications were delivered at each 20% progress milestone. Specifically, users who received the multi-chapter version were provided the first three chapters, given the three-week study duration, while for users in the single chapter group, the same chapter was replayed each week, which resembles the experience that influential UbiFit and UbiGreen style interfaces support, and that allowed us to investigate how episodic structure within a single chapter versus across multiple chapters impacts experience with the system and ongoing motivation. So now I'll touch on a few main results related to how we observe the system affecting people's everyday exercise activities and attitudes, as well as engagement with the interface and story. So first, in terms of exercise behavior, did the narrative seem to impact it? Yes. We saw participants setting a variety of goals from walking and running to strength training, yoga, house cleaning, But regarding progress towards those goals, people who got the multi-chapter feedback did seem to fare better, with 6 out of 8 of them achieving all 100% of their goals compared to only 2 out of 8 participants in the single chapter conditions reaching their targets. And that wasn't because they simply set fewer or easier goals. Multi-chapter participants actually set more goals that were more challenging. Overall, participants logged a total of 1,065 activities, around 82% of them automatically and 18% manually. But again, activity levels did vary with condition, shown here. Specifically, while the average number of logged activities dropped off after the second week for everyone, single chapter participants dropped over 43% from week 2 to 3, while the multi-chapter experience seemed to buffer the decline, with those participants decreasing less than 15%. Plus, in terms of the actual duration of activities, exercise duration progressively decreased each week for single chapter participants, while multi-chapter participants remained relatively stable across the study, even climbing ever so slightly from week 2 to 3. Beyond behavior, we're also interested in examining psychological attitudes, which can moderate the relationship between exercise and health. Analyzing survey questions based on the trans-theoretical model of behavior change, which conceptualizes a person's awareness of the need to change and readiness to do so, we found that half of multi-chapter participants advanced at least one psychological stage, whereas only one single-chapter participant advanced, 5 showed no change, and the remaining 2 participants actually showed reverse psychological progress in terms of their readiness and self-efficacy to change behavior. Our survey and interview data also makes us suspect that for individuals in earlier stages of behavior change, the emotional support of the narrative scaffolding may be most motivating, while people in a later stage likely need more instrumental support and depended more on our features like notifications or in-app screens for drilling down into details of their activity traces and progress trends. For instance, one participant who began the study already in the action stage was confident that, quote, "I need more data rather than the story. I needed the numbers and charts." And now moving on to engagement with both the system and story. Based on screen on-off logs, we found that participants who received the multi-chapter narrative glanced at their phone, and in turn, Zuki's ambient display, approximately 30% more on average throughout the study, as you can see in the graph here. Plus, while these screen views increased week to week for multi-chapter participants, screen glances of the single-chapter participants decreased during the final week of the study. In an interview, single-chapter participants explained dwindling interest in the interface once it recycled the same set of content, because they already knew what was going to happen, whereas multi-chapter participants described wanting to periodically check in on Zuki, for example, quote, "just to see how he is, what he's doing." But then we also used the narrative engagement scale to assess key dimensions associated with a story's persuasiveness. And with the exception of realism, which indicates all participants perceived the plots as similarly logical, participants who experienced the multi-chapter version reported greater engagement with Zuki's narrative across all dimensions. And so those are all the results I have time to highlight today. Lots more descriptive findings as well as contextualizing quotes are in the paper. But I did just want to briefly emphasize how this deployment wasn't intended to prove behavior change, which isn't the goal at this stage of HCI research. We'd need a longitudinal study to test sustained effects of the system. Rather, it's important to first undertake these sorts of deep qualitative engagements in situ to establish the system's viability in the wild, including to discover and understand ways it's experienced outside the lab, especially unexpected uses, whether positive or problematic. So in wrapping up, I'd just like to briefly review some opportunities to build on this research. A natural and necessary next step is to undertake those large sample longitudinal deployments, like I just mentioned, and we already have such a study underway. As part of future evaluations, it'll also be desirable to compare the efficacy of narrative-based strategies against other forms of feedback. In particular, compared to the quantitative health reports I criticized at the start of the talk, but which are the standard that most apps deliver, and that in some cases may actually be the most needed kind of information, especially for more physically or psychologically fit individuals, like we observed in the pilot. There's also lots of room to explore the design of more complex narratives that support additional literary principles, maybe thinking about specific genres, writing styles, or collaborative features to share stories, depending on the target populations and contexts of use. For instance, narrative feedback may be especially salient for groups that have a strong oral tradition and introduces opportunities to study cultural differences and develop designs that are sensitive to the needs of diverse users. We can also think about building smart narrative technologies, and our field study participants expressed a desire for more interactivity with the story. So Zuki could perhaps be extended from a passive character to an intelligent agent that directly interacts with the user to proactively deliver personalized activity quests. Overall, we see our system as a platform for exploring the design of these sorts of novel, narrative-centered, intelligent, and interactive tools. More generally, I hope the work I've shared with you today has sparked new ideas for your own research and how it might connect with narrative-based approaches. I think there's an incredibly vast and rich set of directions to pursue going forward, and I'd love to discuss further, so please don't hesitate to get in touch. Thank you.